Where am I? Oh, right. This must be Emma's hometown. Altina. Guess I've kept her pretty worried all this time. She must have fallen asleep watching over me.
Instructor Rain?
Oh. Morning, everyone. Sorry. Looks like I overslept a bit. And we have so much to talk about, too.
Thank goodness! I was almost afraid you'd never wake up!
You guys...
She's not the only one. We've all been ill at ease. Even after we managed to escape, the moment we made it to Eren, you were out for nearly an entire day.
We've all been taking turns waiting ever faithfully by your bedside, old and new Class 7 alike. And I, for one, relish the opportunity to gaze longingly at your sweet sleeping face, like a vision into my future.
Really, Musée? I mean, really?
Floozy's gonna floose. Anyway, stop coddling him already. The guy's a grown-ass man.
So you say, but you were just as eager as the rest of us to stand watch.
Oh yeah, I thought for sure you'd just ditch, going on and on about how much you don't care.
Oh, it was just so sweet. He sat right by your side, the very picture of concern.
Like hell I did! Quit making shit up, you damn snitches!
It's good to have you back with us, Ash. I wasn't sure if you were okay, let alone if I'd ever see you again. Class 7 just wouldn't be the same without you.
Well, what can I say? Shit happens. Besides, I wasn't the one chained up in a workshop. Compared to you, I've had it easy.
I suppose so. And Muse, I know this puts you in a difficult spot, but either way, thank you for coming back. You still have your own moves to play. I understand that. But for now, I'm glad you've decided to be here with us.
As am I. Though frankly, even I'm not quite sure how it happened. I suppose I have no choice but to stay right at your side until I find out.
Glad to hear it.
Ugh, there she goes again.
But it wouldn't be the same without her.
As for you two, Yuna, Kurt, it seems you spared no effort coming to my aid. I can't thank you enough for that.
Oh.
Instructor.
Well, I mean, we kinda owed you, you know? You've come to our rescue plenty of times. It's only right we return the favor.
If there's one thing you've taught us, it's to think and act for ourselves. Having the opportunity to put those lessons into practice was an experience unlike any other. But even then, we owed the bulk of our success to the old Class 7, and everyone else who had our backs.
Still, thank you all the same.
Allie?
Rise and shine, Sleepy Bunny.
Why is everyone here? Oh.
Good morning, Altina. I can only imagine all the struggles and doubts you must have gone through, but you never stopped moving forward with everyone else. I'm proud of you. It's good to be back.
Instructor Rin! I...
All right. Seems we're all forgetting the most important part.
Maybe it's a little unfair of us to steal the first chance, but nevertheless, shall we?
Welcome back, Instructor Rin.
Thank you, everyone. With you, I know I can... No. We're all going to push our way forward. Together.
Right!
Thank you. Thank you. Ah, hello everyone. You seem like you're ready to head off.
I'm so glad to see you've recovered, Reen.
Let's start the match. You win.
Thank you. My turn!
My turn!
My turn!
Let's go!
Oh, yeah. The soul shrine's over this way.
It's a bit further in from the dock.
All right. Let's get going, then.
Ha! Shit!
A powerful foe. Ready yourselves.
Where's this path go?
Down to the dock.
There's a waterfall over there. Truly beautiful.
I've heard about it before, but it truly lives up to its reputation.
It's kind of strange that an island of this size is uninhabited.
It was a rare find, for sure, and a perfect spot for a field study.
There! Got a bite!
This is promising.
It's a whopper!
Hey, how's it hanging? Let me take a peek at the goods. Whoa, not bad. Here's a little something for your troubles.
This one's tough. Be careful.
Form is emptiness. Emptiness is form. First. Second. Third. Fourth. Fifth. Sixth. Seventh. Eighth. Luminous Abyss!
Get away! Molten Storm!
Very well. Behold, the Vander style.
That stone pathway leads up to the shrine.
Let's have a look around first to make sure it's safe.
There's the dock, and the lodge we stayed in for our field studies 2 years back.
Yeah, split rooms between guys and girls, just like our floors at the dorms.
Back then, I could never have imagined that Fee and I would be this close.
Don't go digging up the past like that.
Sounds like old Class 7 wasn't too different from us.
There! Got a bite.
This is promising. Not bad at all.
There. Got a bite.
Nice.
Not bad at all.
There! Got a bite!
This is promising. Not bad at all.
Come to think of it, Milliam was here before as well, wasn't she?
Yes.
We came here after we got info from that Professor Lumen guy.
Yeah. Looking back, it was super weird how he kept popping up wherever we went.
I'm sorry.
It's not something you need to apologize for, Elisa.
All of this leaves me with several questions for Crow.
Now...
Looks like we can make use of this.
Might be a good idea to rest up a bit before heading into the shrine.
Thank you.
Look!
It looks completely different from how it was 2 months ago.
Really?
That's right. The spirit veins have been activated.
It likely has something to do with the rivalries.
Well, only way to find out is to keep going. So you've come.
Oh, you guys showed up a lot faster than I expected. Not fast enough, though. Time's not really on our side here.
Crow?
You're here after all.
You made it plenty clear that we didn't have a choice in the matter. That said, it's good to see you again. You too, Duvali. Thanks for taking the time to meet with us.
Well, what's with the casual hello? We are not friends. Your thanks is nothing more than a pittance to me. Personally, I'd rather not have to see this sordid scene play itself out. But this is the path I've chosen.
Sordid scene?
What does she mean by that?
Well, now that we've got both Class 7s all nice and gathered here, I'll tell you everything I know about the rivalries.
Already? No warm-up monologue or anything?
I'm just glad we're able to get straight to the heart of the matter for once.
All right, then. I'm all ears. Tell me what you know about this tension within me. Within us. I feel it in the air. In the world itself. I feel my heart racing, steeling itself for some inevitable clash it awaits.
The world itself?
I see. So that's how it works.
Sounds like the little lady's got it all figured out. I get the feeling Gaius, Sarah, Emma, and Miss Kitty over there are on the right track, too. Simply put, the rivalries are a struggle for power. Death matches between divine knights. As the world is driven to the brink of annihilation.
That's madness. I knew it.
I saw the parallels with what Vita attempted at the Infernal Castle 2 years ago. Her goal was to trigger a pseudo-rivalry, wasn't it?
Then there's the experiments Ouroboros conducted with the three Ions over the course of the past year. They were trying to see if the rivalries could be artificially reproduced. Is that right?
Yes. I was never privy to the particulars, but they were seeking to awaken the tremendous power brought forth by the fusion of the two Septarians. The experiments were a means to that end. A bid to turn melees into miracles.
That more or less covers it. Vita's been searching for ages for a way to keep the curse in check. The curse of the Great One, the catalyst of the great twilight that ushers in the end of the world. All those clashes between the Divine Knights in the past have just been dress rehearsals at best. As orbital technology advanced, the day soon came when humanity's weapons were powerful enough to conceivably cause the end of the world. And with that, the conditions to begin the rivalry of the Seven were met.
You can't be serious. So it's not that the rivalries are the cause of the world ending.
It's that the rivalries can only occur as the world's being ravaged by war.
Perhaps it'd help to see the world as a sort of crucible. The Great Twilight is the kindling, and war, the bellows that stoke its infernal flame. The further the extent of its strife, the hotter the blaze. As the crucible drowns in fire, the Seven, who were once one, begin their battle within. From there they fight to the death, melting into each other amongst the flames, one by one, until finally, the Seven are reforged into a whole once more.
Come again? It's somewhat akin to the practices of the alchemists of old,
distilling materials into their purest form.
It sounds more to me like a survival of the fittest. A battle royale with one singular victor.
It's both. But on a far larger, far more primal scale than anything we've ever known.
Well, shit.
Seems like this is ringing some bells for you. No surprise there. You're an awakener and a sacrifice. A two-for-one package. You know exactly what it is we have to do. We can feel it in our bones.
So you mean...
You're starting the rivalry right here? Right now?
I'm no Vita, but I know a prime opportunity when I see one. The war hasn't started yet. Maybe if we get a jump on this, we can derail the Gnome's plans. But the second the Empire launches its attack on the Republic...
As the sacrifice, I'd be forced to engage in the rivalries, whether I like it or not. That's all there is to it, right?
Reen!
The curse would take over.
Nail on the head. You'd either go berserk, or your memories would get sealed away, turning you into a mindless puppet. It's one side of the coin, or the other.
Then now may be the last chance I have, before my memories are snatched away. Before I'm forced to duel to the death, devoid of all sense and reason. I can still see this rivalry through with my own eyes. Triumph or fail by my own merit. I stand before you, Crow. As a swordsman of the Eight Leaves and a member of Class 7. Even if it's the last thing I ever do, I'll do so as myself. Reen Schwarzer.
Instructor Reen. Ah, there you go.
Before we begin, the stage must be set. As with the Infernal Castle and Ouroboros' experiments. Appoint 3 allies to assist you. Only then shall we take you on.
So she can do it even without the Stalwritter.
The Radiant Star Formation.
Huh. Guess this is as good a stage as we're gonna get. We don't quite meet the full requirements, but hey, a passing grade's a passing grade. All right, then. This'll be our last dance, Reen. I saved it just for this moment. Just for you, in the throes of the fading twilight.
I'm ready. Let's do this, guys!
Right!
All right, come at us with all you've got.
Holding back won't grant you mercy.
Let's go! Raging Fire Formation! Go! Eternally flow. Form is emptiness. Emptiness is form. First! Second! Third! Fourth! Fifth! Sixth! Seventh! Eight leaves. Luminous Abyss!
My secret weapon! Holy light! Gather in my bow! Take this! Gabriel Arrow! Repent for your sins! I'm far from finished!
Behold! The soul of Arsaid! Now! Radiant Phoenix Blade!
that really all you got?
Behold, the dual blades of Vander. Now, I'll end it. Ha!
Ragnar,
strike!
Get out! They got me.
Time to kick things up a notch!
It's my turn! Now! Let's go, everyone!
Leave it to me!
Understood!
I'll handle this.
Here we go! Shoulder the Cross of Defiance! Cross Rebellion!
I'm up! Crimson Crash!
My turn!
Leave it to me!
Almost there.
This glow. The stage is set. The preparations are complete.
This is as much as I can help. The rest is up to you two.
Right. We're up, Ordeen.
Understood, Pro.
Valimar, heed my call!
Instructor Reen, Milliam.
Short stack. Still glowing red, huh? But whatever. That sword ain't that much stronger than one made out of Zemurian ore.
Don't hold back, Reen. Come at me with all you've got.
Huh? Hey, you in there or what?
Crow, if a rivalry is, at its core, a battle between divine knights, then what about the Awakeners? Since I'm also a sacrifice, I don't know what will happen to me, but you're only being kept alive as an Awakener by the curse. So what'll happen if you, an immortal, were to lose?
Wait. Doesn't that mean he'd...
Well, guess that's what we're here to find out, huh? Gonna have to call you out for acting like you already won, though. You gotta kick things off first. So come on! You better be ready for this, Reen. The world's about to crumble right under your feet. So quit screwing around! Your pathetic opponent's already dead, so put him out of his damn misery!
Fine. But let me make just one thing clear to you. You're not pathetic. You're our friend. A fellow member of Class 7. A rival whose shadow I've long struggled to emerge from. That's all I have to say. Now let's settle this!
Fine by me. Show me what you've got, Reen!
Yeah!
settle this once and for all!
Crow. Okay, let's do this!
I'm up! Turn!
Now, bring it on!
Leave it to me! Yeah!
King! Over here!
Not bad, but we're just getting started. Come at me, Reen. I'll take you on.
Leave it to me. Yeah.
Showtime!
Take this!
It's my turn!
Get back!
Leave it to me! Yeah!
Kim!
Yes! Ha!
Kim!
My turn! Here you go!
It's my turn!
This is it.
We'll keep going for a brighter tomorrow.
Oh.
it's over.
He did it! But...
does this mean the rivalry's complete?
Yeah, looks like our little improv routine did the trick.
What the... it's just as I feared.
I don't understand. Your wounds aren't fatal like they were in the Infernal Castle.
Yeah, you've made it through way worse than this. Stay with us, Crow!
Well, here's your answer. Ordeen's power is Valimar's now. And with it, whatever it was that kept me alive, each successive rivalry will lead you to the root of this curse.
Not another word. You must conserve your strength.
Celine, help me! We can't leave him like this! I'm with you.
You'd think I'd be used to this by now. I guess karma really is a bitch. At least this time, our power can live on through you. Sorry for making you guys go through this a second time. Long as Reen's got you guys on his side, I know he'll be alright. Just do me a solid and bring Jellica back to her senses for me, okay?
Like hell, you've played enough hooky for two lifetimes as it is.
And what about Toa? Or George? They deserve that closure just as much as you.
You guys managed to bring Reen back from the brink. That's no small feat. Guy's a real drama queen, though. Take it from me. Second he starts acting all spoiled and mopey, you pull him right back out, okay?
Stop talking like that! You can't just give up!
Don't you understand how much you mean to him? You're the only one acting spoiled here, Crow.
Instructor Reen.
Hey, what do you think you're... pull yourself together, Crow Armbrust. The world is about to crumble. Not just beneath my feet, but yours as well. Are you really just going to take the easy way out? Now of all times?
Huh. What the... how are you...
Look, Valimar, he's...
stopped absorbing Ordeen's power? That's not it. He's reversing the flow. Inconceivable.
Screw the rivalry. I won't do this to you. I won't be responsible for your death. You're going to live, damn it. You hear me? You're going to fight and struggle and survive no matter what it takes. I won't let you off the hook that easily. You've got a ton of interest to pay back.
They're coming back!
And it's as though something's happening between them.
Yes, perhaps it's...
come back to us, Crow! I need you. We all need you!
We're no quitters, right, Crow?
That voice...
I see. So, all this time...
What's that noise? It sounds like... waves. I... thought we were way down in the Soul Shrine.
Hey, rise and shine, princess.
Give me a break. How many times is he gonna put us through this?
For once, I agree. What will we do with him?
I believe I now understand what it means to feel frustrated.
Guess you'll just have to take it out on him sometime.
Don't you lot ever take anything seriously?
Oh. I remember this place.
Well, I should hope so. This is the lodge on Brionia Island. We brought you here so you could rest a bit.
Oh, sure. It's only been like 6 friggin' hours. You done with your little beauty sleep yet, or what? Try to take it easy on him. You'd be tired too if you went all out the way he did.
Though we do need to start planning for the rivalries to come at some point.
Right, the rivalry. What happened after? Oh. Hey there, Duvali.
Excuse me? That's Duvali the Swift to you. I get the feeling you've become a bit too accustomed to my presence.
Sorry. I was just surprised, is all.
Hey, how's it going? I woke up just a little bit ago, but I can't really move much either. Honestly, I could have used a few more hours in Dreamland.
Crow. Then, everything worked out okay.
Looks that way. Just couldn't let me have my big moment, could you?
And it's good he didn't. It would have been your last otherwise.
Emma, Celine, what exactly happened back there?
I can only make a guess based on the flow of mana, but I believe Valimar has made Ordeen into a servant of sorts.
So, like what the Dark Dragon did to those Calvardians. He's like night-touched, but with a K.
Not quite. Those soldiers were nothing more than slaves to their master's will. In this case, it's more of a matter of kinship, of sharing a spiritual link, like the one Emma and I have.
I see. So it's like my connection with Clown Soleus.
Then the two Divine Knights have become Lord and Retainer, in a certain sense.
It must have extended to the Awakeners, too. Otherwise, Crow would have disappeared by now.
As rivalries go, this one wasn't exactly by the book. Ordeen's still here, for one. Valimar didn't absorb his power.
Well, sounds like a pretty good deal to me. I mean, now we're up a man and a Divine Knight.
Agreed. Ordeen will be a welcome addition to our forces. And with Crow now in our ranks as well, it will make a world of difference.
Oh, counting me in already, huh? Well, no use arguing about it. To the victor goes the spoils. Besides, until we manage to put this great Twilight business to an end, I'm living on borrowed time.
Crow...
Then your ultimate fate remains unchanged.
Yep, any way you slice it, my being here contradicts reality itself. Doesn't matter what you, Adios, or anyone else has to say about it. My fate's not gonna change one bit. Am I right, Gaius? Emma?
Unfortunately so.
As much as we hate to admit it.
Crow.
So what? We're supposed to just let it happen?
There has to be something we can do.
Yuna. Altina.
Screw Adios, then. What's she even good for?
We can worry about that later. Because right here, right now, you're still alive. I won't accept this fate of yours as a hard and fast truth. As long as you're still here, I'm not giving up on you. But for now, I'm just happy you're back with Class 7. Back where you belong.
That's right.
I swear, you're all just as sentimental as ever.
Welcome back, Crow. You're one of us again. So, let's give it all we've got. Just the way we always have.
Ah, screw it. I gotta pay all that interest back one way or another, right?
About time.
See?
seems our lost little lamb has found his way back to the flock.
Honestly, I am in awe of how much time you lot fritter away on sentimentality.
And what of you, then? What do you intend to do from here on?
What I intend to do is none of your concern. This is as far as my charity goes. Come tomorrow, I'll be going bye-bye.
Bye-bye?
So where are you going, then? Can't really do much anymore without the society backing you up, right?
You did mention something about getting to the bottom of Ouroboros' plans. You've got some other allies to fall back on, I take it.
Do you even have a plan to get off this island to begin with?
I'm not too familiar with it, but the Society does employ some form of teleportation technique, as I recall.
If it came down to it, I could simply swim back to Ordis. Yes, that's right!
Your chance of survival caps out at 0%.
Looks like the Swift's been stopped cold.
I guess you can only use their teleportation when you're actively working with them, huh?
Listen, Duvali, I get it. I know things might seem a little weird given all the history between you guys, but things are different now. So how about you and I take a load off and let someone else take the reins for a change?
Excuse me? I think that fight must have addled your brains. What kind of fool do you take me for? I am, or was, a proud member of the Stall Ritter. The very idea is utterly ridiculous.
Maybe so. We do still owe you for backing us up at the Black Workshop. Not to mention the help you've given us here on Brionia. We couldn't have completed the rivalry without you.
Our paths have crossed so often. At this point, it can only be fate. But you may consider it just a temporary arrangement, if you'd like. At least until you figure things out for your own.
In addition, your lord will surely be involved in the rivalries we will face in the near future. Coming along with us could yield quite a wealth of information about her, don't you think?
Well, my lord is most certainly, I suppose, were I to play my cards right.
She always knows just what buttons to push, huh?
This girl's one to watch out for. This is nothing compared to the way she organized the Viceland army. Oh yeah, Muse's got playing people down to an art.
Ahem, if we could get back to the matter at hand. I have decided to help you out a bit. For now. But remember this, Class 7. We are not friends. Our cooperation is one of convenience and nothing more.